Hello world, it's Rahul. Welcome back guys to machine learning tutorial. And today we'll be going to discuss what is bias and how does it work? What is variance and how to mathematically calculate variance on data points? What is overfitting and underfitting and how to avoid this overfitting and underfitting by trading off bias and variance? So guys, I saw that sometimes people get confused about what is bias or should we accept high or low bias during our model training. So let's forget everything and start from fresh. So when we say bias, what does that mean? So guys, if I talk in general, then bias means having a preference for one thing over another. Now, how this fit into statistics or machine learning? So let's quickly take one example to understand this. So guys, suppose I'm working in a weather forecast department. And I have written one program which will predict the weather based on certain features. Now, this program may consistently predicting temperatures that are higher than those actually observed. Let's say my actual temperature is 32 degrees Celsius, but my program is predicting 39 degrees Celsius on day 1. Now, next day, my actual temperature is 34 degrees Celsius. And my program is predicting 42 degrees Celsius. So guys, by looking into these information, I can say that the forecast is biased and somewhere in the system there is a mistake that gives too high an estimate. If the forecast method is unbiased, then it may still predict temperatures that are not correct, but the incorrect temperature will sometimes be higher and sometimes lower than the temperature observed. But in current situation, it is always giving higher value than actual one. So now we can say that when estimates are biased, they are consistently wrong in one direction due to mistakes in the system used for the estimates. So bias is nothing but the difference between actual value and the predicted value. And we can say it error as well. So guys, before understanding how variance affects any machine learning model, let's quickly understand the statistical meaning of term variance. So guys, variance is the variability of model prediction for a given data point or a value which tells us the spread of our data. Now let's quickly take an example to understand what I just said. So here we have a data of students in a class with heights given in centimeters as shown on the screen. So for finding variance, we'll see how much our data is spread from the middle, or you can say from the mean value. Now let's calculate mean first by adding all 5 values and divide it by 5. So we are getting mean as 152. Now we'll subtract each term with mean value and make summation of all these and divide it by total number of terms, that is 5, and we'll get our variance as 346. So guys, if you can see on my screen, lesser the variance value, better our model will perform. Now we can conclude that variance is the change in prediction accuracy of machine learning model between training data and test data. And when I say training data and test data, that means we split our data set into two. One is train set and another one is test set. So after model creation, we try to run model on test data to check the working of model, whether the model is running fine or not. So guys, simply what it means is that if a machine learning model is predicting with an accuracy of X on training data and its prediction accuracy on test data is Y, then variance will be X minus Y. And if this difference is low, then we can say our model is performing good. So now I am assuming that we have clear understanding of bias and variance terms. But I am sure that you have a lot of questions like whether these bias and variance values should be high or low. How can we define it? And will this high or low value affect the machine learning algorithms? And blah blah blah. So guys, definitely we have to make sure about these values while fitting any machine learning algorithm to our dataset, as ignoring high or low bias variance value can highly affect the model output. So let's quickly look into four scenarios when we have low bias and low variance, low bias and high variance, high bias and low variance, high bias and high variance. So guys, here we came up with term overfitting and underfitting. And instead of talking about some definitions or theoretical angle, I feel we should visualize how overfitting and underfitting actually works using real-world example. Guys, let's go back to our school days and consider that you are studying in 10th standard and there are 3 students in your class named as X, Y and Z. Let's say student X is not interested in what is being taught in the class and he is more distracted in his own world. Now, student Y is most competitive student who focuses on memorizing each and every questions being taught in the class instead of focusing on key concepts. Let's consider student Z, who is purely interested in understanding the key concepts and problem solving approach instead of mugging up the things that taught in the class. So, as we all know from experience what happens in a classroom, after delivering lectures, teacher simply takes test on what he taught in the class. So let's discuss what happens when the teacher takes a classroom test at the end of the day. So here is the scorecard of each student on the screen. Student X, who was not interested in paying attention or learning the new things in the class, scored approximately 50% marks by only guessing the answers. Student Y, who memorized everything, was able to score more than 90% marks. Now, on the other hand, student Z solved questions using problem solving approach and scored almost 87% of marks. So guys, we can clearly infer that the student who simply memorized everything is scoring better without much difficulty. Now let's introduce some twist over here. Let's also look at what happens during the final exam. So in the case of student X, things didn't change much and he still randomly answers the questions and gained approximately 48% of marks. But if you can see on the screen, student Y marks has been dropped significantly. Can you guess why? This is because he always memorized the problem that were taught in the class, but this time exam contained questions which he has never seen before. Therefore, his performance went down significantly as he didn't know how to solve new problems. Now, you'll see very interesting outcome for student C. So you can see that the marks remained more or less the same as he focused on learning the problem-solving approach instead of memorizing and able to solve the unknown questions as well. So guys, if you are thinking about how does this relate to overfitting and underfitting concept, then let me tell you that we are considering these scorecards as training and test data as shown on the screen. So guys, class test will come under training data and final exam will come under test data. Now, segregate this data for each student as shown on the screen. And guys, before moving ahead, let me tell you that bias defines how much accurate our model is performing on training data and variance tells how much accurate model is performing on test data. So guys, by looking into student X scorecard, we can say that on training data we are getting low marks, that is 50%. It means if I subtract this from 100, we'll get error of 50, which is very high. So by using this information, now I can say that here our bias is high. And if I relate test data, that is 48% marks, with variance, then I can say that accuracy on training data minus accuracy on test data, that is 50 minus 48 is 2, and that is very low. So guys, when we have a case of high bias and low variance, we can say that our model is underfitting the data as model is not learning in any of the case. So in this situation, model will always aim off the target but being consistent, as you can understand through student X scorecard in both scenarios. So guys, student Y is a perfect example of overfitting condition as it's performing really well on training data with only 5% of error, that is 100 minus 95. But on test data, it is significantly dropping and we are getting variance as 95 minus 64 equal to 31, which is very high. So we can conclude that when we are having low bias and high variance, then we can say our model is overfitting on the data, where model is aiming at the target but not hitting it consistently. And guys, last but not the least, student Z, who has scored almost same for both the conditions, is a perfect example of best fit, where model is having low bias and low variance with values 100 minus 87, 13, and 87 minus 85 is 2. So guys, in a nutshell, we can say now that our model must have low bias and low variance value for better performance, as this time model aims at the target and hit it with good precision. Now question arises, what if our model is coming under overfitting and underfitting condition or high bias and variance value? Should we drop that model and creating it again from scratch? So guys, answer will be no. You just have to trade off the bias and variance. So let's understand what is bias variance trade-off. Suppose we denote the variable we are trying to predict as y and our dependent variable as x. We may assume that there is a relationship relating one to another, such as y is equal to fx plus e, where e is the error term and it is normally distributed with a mean of 0, like shown on the screen. Now we may estimate a model of fx using any modeling technique. So the expected square prediction error at point x will be error of x equal to expected value of square of y minus estimate outcome. And this error may then be decomposed into bias and variance components as shown on the screen. So how are bias and variance related to mean square error? Let's see the mathematical derivation of this. So as we have already seen formula for error earlier, here we'll apply a minus b whole square on this equation and find expected value for each term as shown on the screen. So guys, just to add one thing, expected value for constant will always be constant. Now we have an equation of f square minus twice of f and expected value of estimated function plus expected value of squared estimated function. Now let's calculate other quantity as shown in the equation. We can see that we have proved the square of bias plus variance is nothing but the mean square error value with some error. So guys, by this way we can reduce these error and prevent the model from high bias and variance or overfitting and underfitting. Further, we have some techniques to reduce this error, that is using bagging and resampling techniques, adjusting minor values in algorithms, maintaining separate training and test sets, model optimizations by using systematic cross-validation. So guys, these techniques we'll see in upcoming session. Thank you guys for your time. Do like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.